Hello, my name is Jessica Bell, and I'm the Director of the Library and Instructional Design here at the Institute. And I'm going to be talking to you about the Pico method for asking an answerable clinical question. And I have to tell you, this can really save you a lot of time as you're getting organized about your topic, and then also when you actually get to the databases to start searching, it can make your life a lot easier. So let's jump right in. As you may have suspected, Pico is an acronym, and each of the letters stands for an element that every clinical question should have. Well, of course, aside from the one in parentheses, but we'll get to that. P is population, I intervention, although we'll get back to that, C comparison, O outcome, and T time. And so let's take each one of these. Population, of course, is where you define who you're looking at. And so this can be as general as cancer, and oftentimes when starting out, you are very general. Or it could be as specific as stage 2 breast cancer, and perhaps even with African American women over 50. So this is where you can really narrow in. All right, so now intervention. And as I said, we would get back to this one because actually, I think they use the I because it works well in the acronym. But this is really where you look at whatever clinical idea you're talking about. So let me give you an example. So intervention, certainly, if you're looking at a treatment for a condition. But this is also where you might put in a diagnostic tool. So ultrasound or x-ray or whatever it might be. But it could also be prognosis. It could be exposure. If a person is exposed to X element, are they more likely to contract Y? That sort of thing. So although it says intervention, it's any of those elements. Comparison. So here is the thing that we are comparing to our intervention or diagnostic tool or whatever it might be, to see whether it was effective or likely or whatever the question is. So just so I can stop saying or whatever, let's go ahead and focus on an intervention. So your comparison is generally going to be either another type of treatment, and frequently that's going to be sort of the gold standard or the typical treatment, or placebo or doing nothing. So that is an option. Your comparison could be nothing. Outcome. So this one is the part where you define what it is you're hoping to have happen. Are you hoping to have reduced rates of something, reduced likelihood? Are you hoping to have more of something? Are you hoping to cure whatever condition it is? What are you looking to have happen, to have that intervention do or have that diagnostic tool do? And here's where you put that in. So all of these elements do work together very closely. Okay, so finally, timing. And as I said, this one is in parentheses because it's kind of optional in that not every topic is going to require this element. So for example, there are some topics, let's say anxiety disorder during pregnancy. I don't know why I'm stuck on anxiety disorder. But let's say you were looking at it 6 months postpartum. So that would be a kind of timing element. Or let's say you were looking at some drug side effects and you wanted to see what they were 6 months into taking the drug, as opposed to a year or 3 months or something. If there was something that was important timing-wise about your topic, this is a reminder to put that in there. Okay, so let's get to an example. Okay, so I'm going to use a very general example because, or non-specific, I should say, because frequently when you're starting out, you don't have a lot of specifics yet. You probably have a population and you probably have an outcome, but you may or may not be clear on the I and the C elements and if there's a T at all. So here we have, I was going to take a look at reduced headache in people who have migraine, and I wanted to look at non-pharmacologic versus pharmacologic intervention. So again, very general. This is, and in fact, this isn't even ready to get into the databases yet or into searching something like Medline or PubMed yet, because it doesn't have a lot of specific elements. But this helps me at least map out the direction I'm going in. From here, I might recommend going into a database like DynaMed, And I think there's a link to it on the left side of this guide, the guide page. And what that database can do for you is help you see what literature's out there. It gives you a nice synopsis of what research has been done on a topic. So you can look up something like migraine, and it will tell you if you're interested in diagnosis. You can click on the link for diagnosis, and it will show you an outline of the different types of diagnostic tools, the research that's been done about them. The same goes for treatment, and so it's a nice way to get familiar with what's out there and can help you really craft your Pico question. Okay, and as you can see, I don't have an element of time here. I may introduce it back in if, as I become more familiar with the literature, I realize, oh, this is important when a pharmacologic agent is given or not given or whatever it might be. But for now, I don't think I have anything to go in this spot, so I'm just going to take it away. And then I'm going to begin to take away the Pico elements and really start thinking about this as the database terms I'm going to use for my search. And so now I need to make them more specific. All right, so let's say I did take a look in DynaMed or UpToDate or one of those databases, and I did some poking around and I found ways to make these more specific. So in this case, I said it's not just migraine, it's non-responsive migraine. It's not non-pharmacologic, but I'm actually going to choose something specific. I'm going to choose cognitive behavioral therapy and triptans. And for the pharmacologic, compare it to just taking triptans. And then finally, the outcome being reduced headache, but in this case, I actually added on reduced headache and reduced triptan use. So I've really narrowed in on the kind of literature I'm looking for. And now I'll take these more specific terms and bring them to Medline or CINAHL or PsycINFO and put them in to and combine them to find literature that's going to be relevant. Now, so that, but that of course is for some different tutorials that you'll find on this same guide, how to actually search those databases. But the thing to keep in mind too, that many of those tutorials won't help you do is that you may have to be flexible with your search terms and not only the terms themselves. So, looking at different ways to call something. Do you call it triptans? Do you call them by a brand name? What do you call it? How do you get to the idea of reduced triptan use? So thinking about ways to call things, but also different combinations. There may not always be literature on exactly what you're looking for, so you may need to remove elements here or there, and get to general ideas so that you can make inferences from the literature. But so that's going to be something that's going to vary from topic to topic. But from here, what you want to do is practice with your own topic, and then go ahead and look at some of those tutorials for searching Medline or CINAHL. And then get to it and find all that great literature.